Hey girl, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ashley Bedeck, and today we're gonna be doing some crimps. I went ahead and did this beautiful start to finish beginner friendly install. This one does come courtesy of Klaiyi hair. I wanted to give like real baby hair. Like I wanted to give the forehead vibe. I wanted to bond down, but I wanted to give like not big, long, thick swoops. You guys haven't seen me use one of these in a while, and I feel like we don't use these enough. They make the best beautiful wavy texture. Right now it's still like setting. I didn't like comb it apart because I like mine to just naturally fall apart, and then it just like a beautiful natural wavy texture. It's a vibe to me, and spring will be here before you know it, and this is going to be probably my go-to look for spring. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into the tutorial. We'll start with the install and then we'll get into the style. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. Now let's get into it.
Okay, ladies, let's get right into it. This is a quick peek at the packaging. I'll show you a little bit later all of the details. This is the dust bag, and then this is the wig, literally straight out of the box. For reference, she is a 24-inch balayage highlight body wave lace wig. I love, love, love the fact that this one is so beautiful and the texture is amazing. This is a look at the inside construction of the cap. You do get a full frontal cap with free parting, so you can do a center part, a side part, or whatever you choose. And this is what she looks like on. The dramatics of it all are so funny to me, but I really, really love this color combo against my skin tone already. As I mentioned, she is a body wave texture, and the body wave, it's definitely body waving. Here's a closer look at the hairline. I like to show you guys all of the details and specs so that if you are on a hunt for a wig of this caliber, you can know exactly what you're getting to in purchasing. The body wave, again, for the third time, is body waving. I love the color. I love the fact that this body wave is so defined. To me, you can cut the lace and install and you are literally ready to go. I highly recommend just enjoying the texture that it comes with before putting any heat into it, but we are going to amp it up with crimps today. Before we do that, let's go ahead and do our install. So I'm just taking a pair of scissors, and you guys can see I kind of do a little bit of a wiggle movement with cutting the lace. I cut off half the lace and realized that my sideburns needed to be pushed back. I'm going to use this edge control that smells amazing from my line, bedeckbeauty.com. And I'm not flicking you guys off intentionally, my apologies, but I find that when you're baby hair and your sideburns are like flat and like edge controlled and pushed back, it's better because like when they're free and they're moving around, like you see I'm cutting around my ear, sometimes I find myself accidentally snipping into my actual sideburns and cutting the hair off. So yeah, make sure that your stuff, your edge control and all that, it's working, because you can and will cut your edges. Now let's go ahead and do the install. I tried something a little bit different. You guys have seen me use the spritz a few times in recent weeks or even months. I've never actually tried using it as a full-on lace adhesive. Of course, it's glueless, but it has that tacky feel, so you can definitely use it. I think I am fluent in using like aerosol cans where the spray is like even, but using this and it having such a sharp spritz, it definitely did get a lot more messy than I intended, but it definitely does work. I ended up spraying like a good amount onto my countertop and just using my finger to like dab into the product and then like applying it directly to my skin where I wanted it to be. And that was like the cleanest, neatest way to do it. Be sure to like dab off any excess product off your forehead, like using a towel like I do, before you blow dry, because like that product will dry like shiny on your forehead and it'll have just that residue unclean look. I also went ahead, because this wig does fit my head pretty much glueless, I was able to apply the product, add the lace on top, and it sit there and not move, and I didn't have to hold it down. So instead of just going in and drawing my bond down, I did go ahead and pull the baby hair forward first. I blow dried it on a cool setting until it was completely bonded down. Then I cut the baby hair super short. Now I'm going to go in with the edge control again and just apply it across the entire perimeter of the hairline. And then I'm just taking my baby hair brush and just applying more product as needed and just moving the hair in a way that, you know, I see fit. For me, I don't like it to look too uniform. As you guys can see, it just looks like baby hair straight across. So I am trying to just work with what I have without customization and just move some of the hair backwards, move it in different directions, and try to just get it to just not look so uniform. I will go back in and tweeze a little bit of it out or push some more back as needed. But I just really wanted it to look like, you know, when the girls have their hair messy and curly in a bun or ponytail, and your baby hair natural, the hair that is actually baby hair just kind of like falls naturally. That's kind of the vibe I was going for. I can perfect it definitely a little bit more, but I'm happy where it's at right now. Now let's go in for the dynamic duo. You guys know this is key. You don't just install and work on the ends. Where the lace is extremely important, especially during the parting in the hairline area. You want to make sure that it's flat and it's neat and it's clean. And this is going to give you the confidence to really just wear the ends of the hair however it happens or however you want. I personally find that, you know, when it comes to my textured hair like body wave or curly, I prefer them to be heatless and in a natural state as far as the length of the hair goes, especially when the hair is so defined the way this hair is. But again, for the sake of the video, I did want to go ahead and give you guys a, you know, style, something, an option for how to treat the hair or style the hair to amp it up. Now let's go ahead and tint the lace. You guys know I like to use makeup products for mine personally. I am a lover of the Fenty concealer along the parting most days, and that's what I use today. And then I'm using the Fit Me foundation along the hairline just to make the lace seamless and to blend with my skin. I think the one I use is like 360 coconut, or I'm going to look at it and have the exact color in the description box. But I find that what I love about this color is that when I don't wear makeup, it matches my skin, and then when I do wear makeup, it also matches. And so that looks beautiful and everything looks clean. At this point, you are good to go. You don't have to do anything. You can add like an oil sheen or a serum to the ends if you want. You can even add mousse if you want to like scrunch and define. For me, I went ahead and added a heat protectant, and we're going to go ahead and work that in because yes, we are going to crimp the hair. I went ahead and just sectioned out half the hair and worked in sections. Now I'm going to go in and just, you know, watch some YouTube and crimp. So this is a prototype from my line, bedeckbeauty.com. You guys know we do offer hot tools. Right now, the only thing available is the flat irons, but I do want to manifest and focus. It's not about manifesting, it's about focusing on my business and expanding. Give you guys a full line of these hot tools. Let me know what you guys think. I want to include the flat iron, the mini flat iron that works for baby hair, the blow dryer, which we have on the site but is currently out of stock, and I'm gonna put it back up, and then this crimping iron, and then also the wand curler. So feel free to leave in the comments your thoughts and opinions. Should I make it a full line? Do you guys like the bling or not? As I'm running my mouth, this is what we have so far. Because this is a larger barrel, I'm able to use bigger sections, and I'm just going in and just getting a piece as close as I can to the root, holding it for a few seconds, and then moving down. And this is definitely a beautiful, beautiful way to amp up a body wave texture. You guys can see it's very similar to the body wave, but it's just a lot more defined.
The glow up is real, baby. I am done with the crimps, and honestly, it's a very, I'm not going to say it's a fast process, but it's a very efficient process if you just have a little bit of patience. You know how sometimes you curl your hair if you don't know how to curl, and you get through it and you comb it and the curls drop? I feel like crimps always work. It's just a matter of holding your hair in place each little crimp, you know what I mean? So not gonna pull them apart, there's no need to. They naturally will like drop and connect and fall in place. Now sometimes what I like is like when each crimp, like this was one, I like when they kind of like come together and are perfect. It's easiest or most accurate or efficient, I'm coming up with all these words, to do it like on a wig head, like off your head, or if you're doing somebody else's hair, to make sure that they line up. Because child, after a while, you just start going and you're not really matching the curling iron or the crimper up as efficient. But it's been a while since I've done crimp, so I'm excited to have these. I did use this crimping iron, and this is a sample from my line. You guys know bedeckbeauty.com is my line, and we do have our bling hot comb. I'm just a black girl, especially when it comes to hot tools. I hate the fact that hot tools naturally from just like using hairspray and hair product will easily just get so dirty and filthy, which is why our line The hot tools are all black with my logo in pink. That is the crimper. This is the blow dryer, which I didn't bring back, but this is the same line. It's just, this was one of the prototypes. I have it in the pink, I have it in the black, and then I have it in the this color. And I wanted to get the blow dryers and the crimpers in this color too. But again, just the wear and tear of it, it just made sense. I was gonna just start off with one color to do this one. Let me know what you guys think. Should we expand? Should we do the blow dryers again? I haven't brought them back yet, but I'm thinking about doing it soon. And then should we just do everything in this color? I also thought about just making it a complete line and doing like the mini flat irons as well as the regular size flat irons. And then you have your hot comb and then your blow dryer. And then maybe even I can do like the wand curlers. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys like the idea, I can get in touch with my manufacturer and get the products made up soon so that we can put them for pre-order on the site so that you guys can have them either by spring. I think that will be a fun thing because shipping is going to take a couple weeks. But anyways, this is the look, and it came from Klaiyi. You guys know Klaiyi hair is one of the girls that always come through with a really, 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 really good product. I love their hair. It always holds up. It always holds a curl. It's always nice. It never smells. It never sheds or tangles, too much. The installs are very easy. It's just a very good quality of hair, which is why you kind of see me pretty much work with them. It feels like almost once a month, even if like almost once a month. Sometimes it's not once a month, but basically I work with them consistently because I really do look forward to their emails and their cooperation because they're lit. So they did give me some packages or some goodies. This here is a robe. You guys have seen me rock this robe many a times. I may give it away, so I don't want to open it up because I literally have like maybe 6, 7, 8 of those robes. And then this here is the dust bag. And this has some goodies in it. You guys can see, got a little girth to it. You already know, keep your dust bag. Inside are some wig caps. Oh, these are pretty. I wish I would have seen these or they would have sent this during Christmas. But look how beautiful these Christmas nails are. I'm literally going to put this in my stash because when it's time to take like family photos for Christmas next year, these are going to be perfect with the snowflake. But I wish I would have had this package before because I definitely would have popped those out. This here is a melt belt and it does match the robe. So how fire is that? Especially like when you have company or when you like are out of town on vacation, to have your robe and your melt belt when you're walking around just match, or just even at home when you have company and stuff, looking like neat and uniform. This here is a kabuki brush. This here is some mink lashes. And then this is another melt belt. I'm a cheetah girl, so you guys know I love this. This is the hair itself. You guys can see it's a beautiful ombre. We have our dark root. I did set it as a center part, which it came as a center part initially anyways. And we have this beautiful brown going on. And it's nice. It's full. It's long. My crimps are not sparse at all. It held the crimp and it gave me no problems at all. So you can definitely check this one out in the description box. I hope you guys are enjoying the new year. Hope you guys are following me on TikTok, ashleybedeck official there. And then just ashleybedeck on Instagram. Follow up, subscribe. I've been posting some content and I'm excited for this week to just really, really get in my TikTok bag. So thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, I'll see you in the next one. Smooches.